As Israel continues to target Gaza with airstrikes, the start of a ground offensive appears increasingly likely. The country's defence minister has told tens of thousands of Israeli troops to be ready for the invasion order. Today, US President Joe Biden announced he will ask Congress for $100 billion in military assistance for Ukraine and Israel. He says the funding for both countries is vital for America's national security.
History has taught us that when terrorists don't pay a price for their terror, when dictators don't pay a price for their aggression, they cause more chaos and death and more destruction.
10 News First Europe correspondent Johnpaul Gonzo is on the ground in Tel Aviv. Johnpaul, the ground offensive on Gaza, it's been looming for about a week, but how's it looking now?
Well, Rob, the feeling here is that it is more imminent than ever, and we are seeing more and more indications of that. The military build-up is continuing on the southern border. The country's defence minister has also visited troops, promising them that they will soon see Gaza from the inside. And on the northern border with Lebanon, Israel is now evacuating town upon town there, concerned that attacks from Hezbollah could increase dramatically when that ground invasion of Gaza begins.
President Biden seems to be walking a fine line. He's offering support to Israel, but also has a commitment to the Palestinians with their self-determination. How is his address being received locally?
Well, that address came in the early hours of the morning here, local time, so Israelis are waking up to that this morning. They will welcome that support, another show of solidarity from Joe Biden. He is a president who positions himself not just as an ally, but a dear friend and staunch defender of Israel, and he insists that he understands this region's troubled history. I think the question, though, there that you alluded to is that does that support remain unconditional for Israel? The US has urged the country not to be consumed by rage and also to show restraint to protect civilian lives. But it's unclear if Israel can actually uphold that when that ground invasion begins.
Johnpaul, is there an update on supplies getting in to help those who need it in Gaza?
So the crossing at Rafah on the Egypt-Gaza border was expected to open today, but that now appears to have been delayed. It might not open until tomorrow or even into the coming days. The US is still trying to hammer out a deal between Israel and Egypt to allow the safe passage of humanitarian help. Israel deeply worried that those supplies could fall into the hands of Hamas. There's very little movement for those trucks in that convoy that are waiting to get through, but we are hearing that roads are being repaired that were bomb damaged. So potentially we could see some aid start to flow soon, hopefully. Humanitarian groups, well, they say that the delay to those deliveries has undoubtedly cost Palestinian lives, and that first convoy of trucks is just a drop in the ocean to what is really needed for people there.
Well, we appreciate the update. Thanks, Johnpaul. Stay safe.